Autumn scenes in Paris often look like a master painting. Dubbed the capital of art by some, the city's streets seem to be constantly immersed in an artistic glow. Anyone who dreams of becoming a painter can easily fall in love with this city. Over 70 years ago, a young Chinese painter decided to leave this dreamlike city and return to his turbulent homeland. Cheng Shuhong graduated from École Nationale in Paris. What attracted him in particular were the albums Les Grottos de Tuan Huang. The photos in the album were taken in 1907 by French explorer Paul Pelliot at the Morgao Grottos in Dunhuang in northwest China's Gansu province. The album contains over 300 photos of murals and sculptures. Cheng was taken aback when he saw the photos for the first time. In his memoirs, he wrote, "The magnificent Dunhuang murals are comparable to Byzantine paintings from the 5th century, especially the flying apsaras, or heavenly beings. The works exhibit strong, solid strokes, and are even bolder than Western modern fauvism. But in fact, they were created 1,500 years ago by Chinese painters." Just a glimpse at the Dunhuang murals beside the Seine River led 32-year-old Cheng to give up his comfortable life in Paris and return to China. Since then, he's never left Dunhuang. In May 2012, Taiwan dancer Shen Qiong Hua made her fifth trip to Dunhuang. What brought her here were also the flying apsaras depicted in the grottos. In addition to Shen, another dancer, Gao Jinrong, has also arrived in Dunhuang.
对对对，是是是是。这边的，是。这幅造型做的特别漂亮，特别美。它记得鼓，现在我们把它叫腰鼓，啊，这和你现在身上做的很相像，是吧？Gao
made her first visit to Dunhuang back in 1979. It was Cheng Shuhong who brought her into this realm of flying apsaras.
常春红先生那儿的所长，他告诉我他手里边有100多幅这个敦煌舞姿的那个白描图，啊，那么我当时我是满我的所有的办公室的墙面，全部贴的是这些白描图，都贴满了，我在里边是要分析它，要琢磨它。 琢磨他的动力，就琢磨他，就说当他火起来的时候会是什么样。
Chung was attracted by the touching figures of the flying apsaras, while the dancers were enchanted by the figures' graceful flowing moves. In ancient times, travelers, merchants, and monks crossed the Ta Kla Ma Khen Desert along the Silk Road. Dung Huang and the Mor Gao Grotto serve as beacons, drawing them in to rest their spiritual minds. Starting from the 4th century, the Mor Gao Grottos underwent construction that went on for more than 1,000 years. Work eventually stopped in the 14th century. Generations of painters and sculptors turned their faith and creativity into the grottos we see today. Some scholars argue that the Mor Gao Grotto's 1,000-year history makes them one of Buddhism's most artistic treasures. In addition, the grottos preserve a wealth of knowledge about ancient music and dance. There are more than 4,500 images of flying apsaras depicted in the Mor Gao murals, as well as more than 3,400 images of dancers and musicians, 500 bands, and at least 6,000 musical instruments. They undoubtedly depict the largest dancing and singing troupe in the world. Although these flying apsaras reflect Buddhist traditions, they mainly use musical instruments from the secular world and are shown dancing like human beings. These images are useful to researchers who study ancient dancing styles that were popular in China's central plains and western regions. They're also a priceless treasure trove for modern musicians and dancers.
Ah, 太美了，怎么会这样啊？ 特别看到敦煌壁画以后，我想都会 浮想联翩，都会有创作的欲望，都会有激动的心情。
The Mor Gao Grottos depict scenes of dancing, singing, and a banquet that have been going on for over 1,000 years. The stars of the banquet are these flying apsaras. In Buddhism, flying apsaras are also called Gandharvas, beings that can fly through the air, immersed with musical talent.
我们讲祭月天呢，它是一个特别的概念。天这个概念是佛教当中的一个特殊的一个阶层，以那个菩萨的这个地位要低一点。天，那佛教讲诸天，天人。 那么这些天人呢，他是实际上是作为佛或者菩萨的侍从，他可以在天上自由的飞翔，来来回回的飞。所以祭月天呢，是指佛教世界的这一类这个天人。
In the Buddhist world, the flying apsaras are free to enjoy the vast expanse of the sky. They dance, they sing, and scatter flowers, creating a happy and peaceful atmosphere which complements the solemn and serious parts of the Buddhist world.
留给我是印象最深的这个敦煌壁画中间飞天的印象是第一位的，让我感觉到一种好像是一种梦想中间的梦幻世界那种东西。
Thousands of years ago, these flying apsaras flew out of ancient India. They traveled eastwards, scattering flowers on their way before finally arriving at Dun Huang. Deep in the grottos, they've left their mark as the most beautiful dancing figures ever found in China. Of the 492 Morgao grottos, 270 have flying apsaras on their walls. Including the other grottos nearby, there are more than 6,000 images of flying apsaras here at Dun Huang. The flying apsaras are the soul of Dun Huang, which itself acts as their final home.
在印度也看不见了，阿富汗也再看不见了，巴基斯坦也再没有了。现在中国这种飞天，它完全是按照中国人的社会风情，甚至人物的这种造型来设计的。
As well as their vast numbers.The Dun Huang flying apsaras also encompass more than 10 dynasties. The characteristics of each dynasty are depicted in each set of images. Experts can see the entire development and localization process of the flying apsaras in China here.
中国的艺术家就把这个飞天塑造成中国式的一种神仙了。这一点呢，恰好我们在印度很少看到，印度的飞天都是画的这个身体很强壮的，好像是飞不起来会跌下来的那样一种感觉。
Despite the gentle features of the more recent flying apsaras, the early ones were not female but male. They look short, strong, and heavy.And seem to bear features which are both Indian and male. In the 6th century, new images began to appear in the Morgao grottos. The flying apsaras became much thinner and more elegant. Grotto number 285 even has a pair of naked flying apsaras, one male and one female.Which some experts found quite shocking.
在印度教当中，他就明确的对这个男根的崇拜，还有女婴的这些情况呢，就是他这个民族的一些特点。那么他们就当然不避讳，就是男女在一起，甚至是做爱的场面。在很多雕刻当中，我们会发现有些裸体的飞天，男的女的在一起的。
Grottos built during the Sui dynasty, images of flying apsaras completely lack any Indian features. From then, they took on a more feminine look, with features of Chinese women of the central plains.
From Sui 代开始，飞天趋向于女性，而且越来越女性化，就表现了女性的曲线，都是在壁画里逐渐形成的。一直到唐代以后。
In the Tang Dynasty, the flying apsaras were transformed from slim but rather cold images into attractive and sensuous imperial dancers. It was a golden age for the Dunhuang flying apsaras. Wearing luxurious clothing and with elegant postures, they are clearly Chinese. It was the high point of this artistic style. Flying apsaras don't have wings. Instead, they fly by using long ribbons.
在欧洲的飞也有天使，但都是用那个翅膀来表现，这个很太简陋了，翅膀太简易了。我们中国就我们的文化，用飘带这么一飘，空间一用，这舞蹈舞姿这么一表现，太丰富了。看到敦煌壁画，就被那个它的那个动感和飘感。 所感动，当时一个强烈的一个感觉，一个符号就是敦煌艺术是个飘带的艺术。如果它没有这些飘带，它就完全不是今天这种感觉了。
It was Peking opera master Mei Lan Fung who brought the ribbon art of the Dunhuang flying apsaras to life on stage. In the Peking opera. Flying apsaras scattering flowers, he replaced the traditional long sleeves with two long ribbons. This made the concept of Dunhuang flying apsaras popular throughout China. Famous dancer Dai Ailian also showed great interest in the Dunhuang flying apsaras. In 1954, she created the duet dance, Flying Apsaras, which brought the art to a much wider audience. In 1978, the Gansu Provincial Song and Dance Troupe planned a major show based on the Dunhuang Flying Apsaras. The first person they sought for advice was Cheng Shu Hong.
当时常先生就讲，他说这个，那你看西方的舞蹈跟东方舞蹈不一样，因为他是在法国留学的嘛，他看了很多芭蕾舞。 他说芭蕾舞，你看，他都腿直直的，他腿呀，他跳啊，胳膊伸出去也直的。他你看我们东方人的舞的，印度的舞蹈，就代表东方人就跟东方人有些共性的，他就手势特别丰富。啊，这个手吧，这个手从这边提过来，提腕，摊掌。This
is the Dunhuang hand dance created by Professor Gao Jinrong. It's based on the rich gestures depicted in the Dunhuang flying apsaras. Gao was the first person to teach the Dunhuang dance. Over three decades, she organized and categorized the dancing postures shown in the murals. She set the course for Dunhuang dance and created a theoretical foundation for this particular dance genre. The well-known master of Chinese culture, Ji Xian Lin, commented on her book, saying that it was a Dunhuang style dance. To search for the dance's soul, Shan Qiyong Hua has come to Dunhuang once again. Having studied all kinds of dance from childhood, she finds the moves of Dunhuang dance to be magical and beneficial to one's health. She claims the dance can put the mind at peace and benefit those who live busy lives in the city. In 2001, her Dunhuang dancing course began to spread to universities and communities in Taiwan. The dances quickly grew in popularity among locals.
Dunhuang
必须是身体的每个部分，就像那个面条一样，哈，我们兰州的拉条这样拉过来拧过去，要有这种，你才能出来敦煌舞蹈的魅力。
Xu Qi is an expert on Dun Huang dance. For 30 years, she has been trying to find out more about this dance. She's created a new series of moves based on the flying apsaras, bringing more power and force to the dances.
啊，一定是旋拧旋拧啊，然后往下做啊，预备。
At the end of 2012, the Dun Huang Flying Apsaras took to the stage. These elegant young dancers helped breathe new life into the centuries-old dance. The Flying Apsaras haven't left us. They've flown out of the Morgao grottos and are soaring amidst the modern dance world, continuing their artistic life in this magical land. In his twilight years, Cheng Shuhong still couldn't put down his paintbrush. This devout guardian of Dun Huang kept on painting flying apsaras until he passed away in 1994 at the age of 92. According to his last wish, his ashes were to be buried opposite the Morgao grottos. His paintings of flying apsaras have been carved into the cliff at Dun Huang, a place he devoted his entire life to. A stunning mirror, a shocking image. Is this figure really playing the pipa behind her back, or is it a trick of the imagination? Can modern dancers recreate such a magnificent dance move? Join us for part two, playing the pipa behind the back.